Hey guys, and welcome to another video. This video will be episode 19 of my Resonance Rise Let's Play. So, like always, I will quickly show you guys what I did between the episodes, and then I will quickly get going on what I got planned for this episode. So, what I did between the episodes was mainly some tidying up. Back here, instead of just having those, these dimensional transceivers all over the place, and I did some testing and I couldn't get them to work just the way I wanted to do them with liquids, so I decided to just go with ender tanks and just work pretty nice. So this, I also put some signs up here so it basically indicates to what each tank does. So basically this one is the experience used to enter my system, so this one is connected to the farm itself, and this is the expedious leaf. So basically, yeah, I can hook everything up that ever needs liquid XP to this ender tank, and it will be mainly my system will be a buffer for all that XP juice. So yeah, pretty cool. I did the same for lava, pretty nice. And water, I don't have any use for it currently, so I'm simply only putting it into my system for when I need to get buckets of that stuff, for example, but not anything else. Then I also have these two here. I didn't label them yet, but I think they are mob essence. And while I think of it, let me quickly get a bucket. I forgot to set this up. Expert bus. And get this going. Get this going. Nice. It's a bit annoying to sleep if you're with multiple people on the server. So yeah. what else did I do between the episodes? I recreated my hammer. And that's pretty much it. Pretty nice. So, what I got planned for this episode is, if I look at my to-do list, first of all, start making an MFR farm. What I did quite a while ago is mine out this area, but I didn't use it yet, so that's pretty much why. And, oh, wait a minute, I did do something else between the episodes. Almost forgot about it. Okay. So, what I got behind here is just something pretty cool. You know, one of my mottos is pretty much, if it's worth doing, it is worth overdoing. This is a perfect example of what I mean. Yeah. Tons and tons of buildcraft lasers connected to this assembly table, which is hooked up to an I.O. block to my system. So basically, if I reconnect this cable, because these things eat power when they're not active, I found that out, so that's why I disabled it. It was eating like a stack of my Eulorium overnight, and that's not good. So yeah, this is pretty awesome. I might be able to show you when I need some more of these chips, but yeah, pretty cool. And I think that's really all I did. So yeah, let's get going with the MFR farms. So let's see, for that I will need, let's quickly look it up, my factory reloaded. I will need some planters and some, let's see, harvesters. Yeah, these things. So, might as well just add all these recipes in while I'm at it, because I'm probably gonna craft this stuff quite a lot. So, yeah. Factory machine is crafted like that. Then a plant pot is crafted like that. And do I have any bricks in my system? Not much. Get myself some clay out then. I still touch mined a lot of this clay, just, well, because I needed something for those for the next project, which is basically the other stuff, the smeltery. And for that you need a lot of grout, and I also did some preparing while I'm at it, so yeah, pretty cool. And get that going. Cool. Then I need the planter recipe. And then the harvester. Shears are crafted like that. Then golden axe is crafted like... Let me quickly do that manually, because these sticks are pretty messed up, because I'm only using vanilla sticks anyway. So yeah, that's why. Good, and I think that's all I really need for this. So let's see, should I make a separate page for that? I think I do. I got more and more than enough pages for this stuff anyway, so. This is one for Mind Factory Reloaded stuff. Then this goes into the vanilla stuff. And then I should be able to get myself, let's say, 4 planters for now. And I'm missing something. Ah, yeah, the bricks. Hurry up, furnace. And one more. And then I can simply request myself the harvester, which should be easy enough. Nope. Did I put the recipe in? Oh, I guess I only did the planter. What do you know? Harvester. There we go. Put this thing there. And almost done. Then might as well also get myself 4 of these. While I'm at it. And I'm low on plastic. Do I have more rubber? No. Let's see. Quickly grab my tree tap. I should have quite a lot of resin spots down here. I should really automate getting the production of rubber or something like that soon. Because, well, my factory reloaded uses lots and lots of this stuff. And it's always nice to have a bit of a backup. So, yeah. Is that all? I think it is. Oh well. Fly up here. Get this stuff cooking up. And then, how many do I need again? Just for now. I can smelt the other stuff later. So, 2. And that's a little bit more plastic. So, I need at least, well, yeah, just 2 pieces. Or 6. But I'm at it. One more. Blue. Black. Wow, what's up? Okay, yeah, we're definitely lagging a bit right now. And I should, yeah, I should smell this stuff. Guys, I'll be back in just a minute. Hopefully I can find a way to clear the lag off. Okay, there we go. Apparently both Puppycocks and Pokefan were exploring and the TPS got down to 2.5 ticks per second. So yeah, I told them, don't do that. I'll let them know when I'm done, but yeah. Recording and 2.5 ticks per second. Yep, that doesn't match. Okay, so what I need is, I believe for this setup I will also need a normal tank, or open block tanks, I mean, because I want to have a rather fancy system. Of course you can type open blocks there. I need at least 4 of those, and I want to make some sprinklers. Sprinklers are some very nice items from open blocks, which I'll show you why I love them in just a minute. And craft myself some of this stuff. Redstone torch. Quickly letting me know that I'm recording. Okay, so if we get down here. What I want to do is basically have one farm on that side, and I'm not sure if I'm able to put it in the wall right here. I might do, or I might not have enough space. So let me quickly see that. If I get myself some planks. I got myself a stack of that. So yeah. If I would make myself a farm, which is 9x9. Then I will need 1, 2, 3, 4... This will be the center of this thing. So then if I get my drill out. Okay, I won't be able to do a 9x9, of course, on this side. Hmm, too bad. Then I'll guess I'll have to do it on this side. Wait, should I even do a 9x9? Yeah, 9x9s are cool. So, then I'll just quickly do it on this side. Clear that out, make it a bit symmetrical. Then, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So, if this is 9, then if this is the middle. But yeah. And then I need to make it go a lot farther into that side. This thing is like the ultimate god tool of mining. It's awesome though. But like always, the only downside from living in a cave is that it's dark. Okay, let's see. I need to make it a 9x9, so then it's like this. This is 9. Wait, yeah. 1, 2, yeah, 9 from this. Then, yeah. If I can place this thing itself right there. I'll just quickly do one on camera so you guys basically know what it is and what I should be doing, and then I will be able to do the rest just off camera. Because, well, one is cool to see and all. And some more might be a little bit boring. So, then I need to just quickly fill this in with dirt already. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And this is nice. Kill that zombie. This thing is also a very nice sword. Just saying. Okay, this should be pretty good. I'm pretty sure I will. Wow, we got a crowded server today. But yeah, I think this will be pretty much enough for today. Or, yeah, enough stuff for. Wait, what? I forgot what I wanted to say. Don't mind me. When I'm doing random stuff, I keep forgetting what I want to say, and it's not good. Okay. Then this, and then I need to find out what the middle of this room is. In just a minute. Then it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So then it's, wait, 10, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And this is the middle of the room. Nice. So what I should then do is place a, well, first of all, something of a water source. So let me quickly get myself an ender tank. And some lapis. And I'll show you why. I believe it is Sace that has this, but he basically has himself an awesome, amazing water source. So yeah, that's pretty cool. Then put this thing to output. Put one tank right there. And this is working. Then I can put a sprinkler right there. And it's working. As you can see, this is basically what the sprinkler does. It's pretty cool. It both hydrates the blocks and I think it makes them grow a little bit faster. So yeah, that's pretty nice. Let's see. That's 1, 2, 3, 4. That's 9. So I need to break this for the walls. Oh. Earth elemental? What? Huh. What do you know? Evil guys. That sounded evil. Okay, let's see. Fill this up. expand this wall. Light it up a bit. Probably put some fancy kinds of lamps in here or something. I'm not exactly sure yet, but I'm sure I will think of something. Get myself some more planks. Get enough of that stuff creating. And I think this would be pretty nice just to see, like, actual having all these farms. And I'm not exactly sure what I will use all this stuff for, but, you know, having some kind of farm will always be helpful in some way. So, yeah, pretty cool. This up. Then I can... how do I need to put this set up? The planter has to go. I don't want to do this. I didn't exactly think of this through. Like this. Because I think the harvester needs to be exactly underneath this level. So, yeah. This could be an issue with this tank. I know. Let me quickly do this. Yeah, I got a solution. Don't worry. IO blocks. Yeah. What I can do is, hopefully, just place this a little bit further. Then get myself an IO block. And this liquid thingy. Put this thing to output. And then what I need to get myself is a liquid upgrade. And that should be pretty much all I need for this thing. So, let's see. Liquid. Just in there. Forgetting what the exact name is. Just quickly look up remote IO. Flank upgrade. Then fluid transport. Craft myself a bunch of buckets. I hate crafting some things like just once. I mean, might as well just create some stuff multiple times. I'm probably gonna use them anyway, so. Then put this thing in there. And then what I should be able to do is, let's see, if I get out my trusty bag and get myself, I probably put it in this thing. Yeah, that's the IO linker. Then hook this up, this up to this thing. And now this thing is getting water from that source. Yeah, science. Okay, then I should be able to simply place the planter down. Oh, don't do that. And a harvester right. Maybe I can just place it on the opposite side and make some kind of tube system going on the ground. Should be not bad. Turn this thing around. Okay. Let's see. That's cool. Absolutely. Okay, what I should do then is, I think, if I want to, I'm probably going with the extra, or no, not extra utilities, I mean, thermal expansion solution for this stuff. So, get myself a simple chest, and some item ducts, impulse item ducts, yeah, I might as well, have them laying around anyway, or, nah, I don't need them to be impulse, nothing too fast right now, so. Get myself a stack of that stuff. And dump some of this stuff in there. What I don't need. And I believe it's just one servo that I need. Okay. Then, let's quickly check this out. I should be able to simply do something like this. get this chest back there. Then item ducts pumping down there. And this shouldn't be connecting. Nice. Then get this thing hooked up to there. And put it to... Don't need a redstone signal. Then mine a little bit further. And pop up back here. Then let's see. I think I can simply do something like this. Just easy enough. Like a bit to the side. One higher. Like that. Then make this thing run like there. To get myself 2 barrels. Or 18. Doesn't matter. And a power source. So I need some dimensional transceivers. Only need one. And some red. This stuff. Get back here again. I really wish we had morph at some points like this. So I could simply morph to a bed and be able to, well, basically get everywhere that I need. So, get this there. Then my own power line. Fluid, no. Power, receive. And that's working. Hook this up to... Hello? Yeah. Hook this up. Is this getting power now? Yeah, it is. Awesome. Then hook this up. And then I should only get myself a bunch of seeds. I think. That should be really all I need. So let's see. If I do this. Will, or is this working? I'm probably gonna need some of those range upgrades to add this to this thing, but for now, simply see if this is working. Yeah, it is. Nice. Too bad it's too dark in here. Okay, let's see. Now I need to get one of those winch upgrade thingies. So, let's see. If I quickly look this up again. Mine factory reloaded. And then one of these things. Radius upgrade 4, I think is all I really need for now. Yeah. And if not, well, I'll make it a bigger run, but... A radius of 4 should be nice. And this is working nicely. Put some more torches on the wall right there. As you guys can see, this is working just the way I wanted it to. Pretty much. And now... I think I also need one of those upgrades for the harvester. Yeah, of course I do. Hello. Do I also need... I think I need a bigger radius for this thing, because this thing is only a very short radius to begin with. So, darn. Whatever. Yeah, like I said, I should really make myself a rubber farm. Or at least some kind of farm that involves that stuff. Yeah, smelting. But once I got that going, I think that will be pretty good. At least in having like things like wheat and seeds now. So, plastic. Nice. And I should be able to also get myself some bone meal. Because that's also one of the cool features of sprinklers. And pop this thing. Let's see. Right here. And then I should be able to simply put bone meal in this thing. And these things should grow faster than normal. At least I think they should be doing that. And to make sure only seeds go in. Can I do this? Oh, yeah. Simply do this. And place stuff like that. So seeds only go in this thing. And get myself... do I have anything to speed up the growth right here? Besides, of course, bone meal. Yeah. This should suffice. And I hate this not simply one time click right now anymore. But yeah. What can you do about it? Harvester, do your thing. Harvester. Hello. Anything? Hello. Let's see. This should be hooked up right now, so I think it's really all I should be needing to do. If I simply hook this. Oh, no, don't do that. Put it to don't connect. And hope this is working now. It doesn't seem to be. Oh, wait. Yeah, it is. This thing is just being slow. And then... should I be able to see this stuff flowing in there soon? So, let's see. This. Quickly clean up this. And then... is there anything going in there? Hey, there is it. Just like I wanted it to. So now it's basically trying to put seeds into this thing. And if it's not able to, it will simply send all the seeds into this barrel. And then into this one. So this is pretty cool. Fancy. So let's see. How far am I into the recording? Well, I'm already... wow, am I really at 30 minutes already? That went fast. Wow. So, yeah. What I think I'll just quickly do is clean up all this stuff. I'll probably put some nice kind of glass right here. Probably just clear glass. Always nice. Can't go wrong with that stuff. And, of course, fancy this thing up a bit. Like, put some fancy lamps in here. And making this all just look a little bit more nicer than just a plain old farm. Because, well, no one likes that. Right? Yeah. So, thanks for watching, guys. Please leave a rating. If you're new to my channel, feel free to subscribe. Other than that, I hope to see you guys all next time.